Welcome to Narayana Virtual Classes. This is Chandrasekhar, Physics teacher. Today we discuss 6th class Physics assignment 2. So in this assignment 7 questions are given. So very first question is how many poles does a magnet has? Question is how many poles does a magnet has? So a magnet having 2 poles. A magnet having 2 poles. So if you see that image, here the magnet containing 2 poles, north and south pole. So image appearing, so north and south pole. So how many poles are existing magnet has? 2 poles are exists. So that is the answer of that question. Coming to second one, electromagnets are made up of an arrangement of dash coil. So again, electromagnets are made up of an arrangement of dash coil. Electromagnets are arrangement of a wire coil. Electromagnets are made up of a wire coil. So if you see that image here, this is called a wire coil. Coming to third question, which part of the magnet attracts more iron filings? So again, which part of magnet attracts more iron filings? So here magnets attracts by the ends, poles of a bar magnet. Poles of a magnet. So in this place only magnet attracts more. Which part means poles of the magnets which gets more attraction. Coming to the question number 4. What materials are used in making magnets? If you are making magnets, so different types of materials and alloyings are there. So what type of materials? For example, iron, cobalt, nickel, aluminium, so these are all the etcetera, these are all the materials to use in making a magnets, iron, cobalt, nickel, aluminium. So these are all the materials. So next question number 5, how do you separate iron filings from soil? How do you separate iron filings from soil? So if you separate the iron filings, just you have to take some soil around in your school ground. If you take one bar magnet, just you have to roll it on the soil. So observing after some time, after the rolling of the bar magnet, so you should observe that bar magnets, so iron fillings are attracts, more iron fillings are attracts at the ends of the bar magnets. So observing this image here, if you take a bar magnet just roll the that soil, so some particles, some dot particles are attracts the poles of a bar magnet. So just you separate the that dark particles in a paper, you should collect that. So that is the iron filings. So more iron filings are attracts at the ends of the bar magnet only. So this is the answer of 5th question. So coming to the 6th one, do all parts of a magnet have equal strength? Justify your answer with a reference of a bar magnet. Question is, do all parts of a magnet have equal strength? No. So here answer is no. No, all parts of the bar magnets get attracts. So only the mid part of the bar magnet is partially attracts. By the ends of the bar magnet, by the ends of the bar magnet is attracts more filings, more iron particles or magnetic material particles. So here observe in this diagram also. So here north and south, these two poles are attracts more amount of iron filings, like a iron paper clips. So here middle of the that horseshoe magnets cannot get the attraction. Only so north and south pole only it can gets the attraction. So here no parts, that means all parts are not attracts, only end parts, that means poles of a bar magnet only attracts the iron filings. So that is the answer of 6th one. Next, coming to the 7th question, explain with an activity that ends of the bar magnet has more strength. Explain with an activity that ends of the bar magnet has more strength. So if you observing that question, so one small activity is there, just you have to take one paper, on that paper just you have to fill some iron filings uniformly like this, and take one bar magnet besides that paper, inside that paper. So just you should move that bar magnet, so iron filings can get the attraction at the end parts. Most of the iron filings are get attracts at the end parts. If you move that bar magnet, iron filings also moving. So if you observing here, just you have to take one paper and take one bar magnet, iron filings are placed it on that paper. So if you move that bar magnet, so automatically all the iron filings are moving. That means here iron filings are attracts more in the ends part only. So in this diagram also explaining, if you give some that iron particles, all are attracts at the end part only. So in this activity what we conclude that, so here iron filings are mostly attracts by the end parts of the magnet only. So that is the answer of that question. Thank you, students.